Yes. I'll have to find your gear monitor. Put it in here. That's working. You make me smile with my heart. Stop there. Anyway, welcome to the Slambovian Brothers extraterrestrial hillbilly pirate Valentine's Day show. Hope it's going to be good so we impress you people here and also all the people that are watching out there on the television. Quite a few people watched last time and they donated all kinds of money. We were actually able to pay rent that month. It was awesome. So we're trying it again. So anyway, it's nice to be in this room with everybody. It feels good to get out of the cold, right? That helps. I love the cold because I like to get out of it. So we'll start with we'll do a lot of love songs for you tonight because it's Valentine's Day. You know, we're all with our Valentines, and so we don't know what that's gonna be like. We've never done that before, but we're gonna do it tonight. But we'll start with this, and in a kind of abstract way, this is a love song. Actually, maybe you'll hear it tonight. We stole elements from a very lovey love song. In this particular song that you might not have noticed before. What's that song called? There's quotes from Fly Me to the Moon in this, you know? They hide stuff in these Slambovian songs. Can you hear that kicking thing?
Yeah.
We bought one of those log jams that people use, but we just turned it upside down on the stage, see how that works, okay? Okay, well, good luck, everybody. Here we go.
I
right back to Eden. Gonna straighten things out. Gonna find out what causes all the fear and the doubt. Gonna visit that angel with a big flaming sword. Pay the price of admission and then go see the Lord.
Thinking it's going into people's like living rooms and bedrooms, right? Not too nerve-wracking. Our nerves are so slow in Slambovia, even when they get racked, they kind of move slow. So let's say, oh, you know what? So of course we didn't make it simple for ourselves. We did two gigs this weekend already, you know, with the full band, and then we drove about 4 hours to get here, and we started picking songs we were going to do for the show, you know. And, you know, usually if you're going to broadcast, you make sure it's stuff you know how to do pretty good, but somehow we didn't do it. So if everybody out there hates us, we hope you will still, we'll try to make it up for you. We'll give you like $20 bills before you leave, so we got some friends left. This is probably, historically speaking, this is probably the oldest Valentine's Day song that was ever written. It was Adam and Eve mentioned in that last song. Well, this is a song when Eve was dating Lucifer, you know, back in the early days, right after the apple thing happened, you know. Adam was feeling a little bit insecure about it, you know. Lucifer was a lot better looking and smarter, a little bit older than Adam was, you know. He was having a hard time with that. And he wrote this love song for Eve, you know, on Valentine's Day back then. St. Valentine, he was around way back in those days, too. They just didn't talk about it so that people wouldn't get confused with it. That's like, whatever. Both of my grandfathers were tall tale tellers, so. This is terrifying. I have no idea if I know how to play. That's what I have.
Find out.
Okay. You guys are ready for anything, right? Cool. Stretch pants are too tight. Wash them before the show. Sing a little bit more. Put the tuners on guitars. It would have been better if they just let them and you couldn't move them. Does that sound good enough for you?
Pretty good.
You know.
Good enough.
Dopier than usual, right? Tonight. Okay. How's that volume?
Can't find it in a man or angel. Run to the temple, let the flames say what is true. Well, I and then we'll know what love can do. With a little bit of love, it's calling. Simple love that we knew before. With a little bit of love, it's calling back towards the garden wall. With a little bit of love, it's calling. Simple love that we knew before. With a little bit of love, it's calling back towards the flame and soul.
I've never played that standing up before. Can't do it. That sound okay?
Yeah.
Told the story okay and all? Yeah. I was using up all the RAM I got in my brain. We're learning we should review songs before we do it, but we don't. So what am I next? Oh, I said, want to just play and want to do a sing-along with us just to help us out? I'll just do a sing-along for everybody so we're not, you know, I know there's somebody out there with like $3 million. If we play pretty good, you know, they're going to say, I should send those people $3 million. And then we'll hire, we don't want money for ourselves, but we'll hire a big crew. And we'll do the big immersive like Pink Floyd type of show for you guys. And we'll let you in for nothing. Big immersive show. So if you're out there and you got $3 million, you're not doing anything with it, you could send it our way. We'll put it to good use for you. Okay, so we'll do that sing-along, right? That's a good set list, I think, that you picked. Looks pretty good. It's just a little scary stuff in there. So we'll just do a classic love song, but you got to help me on this. This is kind of, it's not up my alley. Seems like the whole show we picked is not up our alley. This is, we're having fun. We just don't want to mess it up for everybody else. Yeah, sure. We did a good job on those past few shows we did. They were really through the roof, and we sold lots of merchandise. That meant, you know, people were voting with their wallets and stuff. But, you know, we inevitably just mess things up in a major way, you know, several times in the show. You think, oh man, people are losing it. They just think, you know, you're messing with it. And people just really like the fact that we're so dumb about stuff. We really appreciate that about you guys. Thank you for loving us and our dumbness. So I better plug this in, speaking of which. So we'll do this song. If I don't remember this, we'll just stop in the middle of it. And then we'll do the one that we do know after it. You know, one of our folky dokey friends, Dar Williams, she loved this song, and that was not, we love Dar's stuff. She's such a great writer, you know, and she really loved this song. She said, that's the revolution song. I think it's because Dar's kind of a kid. She's like a little kid, you know. So this is a song about spaced out kids. It's called, it's a love song among friends, spaced out friends, called Sullivan Lane.
Thank you.
first saw you, you were cruising the blue. You were simple as dew, you were floating away. You were like her and me, spaced out as you could be. Yeah, we know that frequency, come out and play. So down Sullivan Lane, we walked in the rain, like sisters and brothers. Down Sullivan Lane, we slipped from the pain, right into the
What is that chord? This one? Okay, ready? Just study this. One, two, three, two, three.
They taught you how to go, taught you to toe the rope, moved you away, far, far away. But when you think of me, tune in the frequency.
Stumping. This is like, these are stumpers. So let's say a lot, you know, Tank and everybody behind the scenes picked some of the songs for this set, but Sharkey threw in the more difficult ones. He's a much better player than me. Let's say, so we'll play you a big sissy song. We'll play our biggest, sissiest song. We'll play Baby Jane for you. So we're doing okay?
Yeah!
Got a 55 on the test so far, I would say. But that Elvis song, man, you guys kick butt on that one. That sounded good. We should do that one again later on in the set. So anyway, we'll try to catch, gotta just get in the spirit of the songs here. Baby Jane, you know, for us is kind of a precious little song, you know. I've told you in the past, you know, there was a riff from another particular song that we did, this particular riff. My kid liked that riff, and he said, just pull that out of the song and write a whole song on that, you know. So then, as you know, I went up in the attic for a few months playing that little riff until this song came down. And, you know, I think this is definitely written by the ghosts. I've been learning from this song. Kind of a ham-fisted misogynist type guy, but I'm getting more girly. But that for ham fisted misogyny there. Anyway, now this song, we dedicate this song all the time to the invincible spirit of women. Baby Jane. Try to sell, what they're worth I cannot tell. We spend so much time just surviving, we let heaven go to hell. You gotta move on, baby Jane.
Same.
So we'll play you. This is when we recorded the Flapjacks album. You know, 21 song double album. A lot of you have that album, right? Yeah. So we went up to record it. I probably had about 50 or 60 songs that we were sorting through to do that album. And then, but as soon as we hit the record button on the first song, in the first 2 days, about 7 more songs came down. Somehow when we get in the studio and we're ready to go, you know, it just releases a lot of stuff. So, and this is one of the songs that we wrote during that time. Tink had just left. Tink came up to, somebody gave us their house to record it, you know, so we went up to this house to record in it. And Tink made sure we were up and running, and then she had to go back and check on the kids, make sure the kids were okay, that they weren't wrecking the house inside. So she went back, and when I wrote these two songs, I was thinking about Tink in a very apologetic way, you know. I wish she married somebody that like had like a stable income and stuff. Was a little less volatile, a little less dumb. So I wrote this song, and she actually liked it. It's an interesting thing with Tink, you know, when you're playing in the same band with somebody. I wrote a lot of songs, and you think, oh, Tink will be just knocked out by this. She'll just knock me down on some stuff, you know. But she liked this one, even though it's like... Tink's more like a boxer than she is, you know, like a sweetie pie kind of person. A little more like Popeye than olive oil. But she liked this song. I was really happy she liked it. It's kind of like, I grew up doing country stuff with my father, so there's always the country end of things in the songs that we do. So it's always a little bit of like Pink Floyd and a little bit of Johnny Cash going on and some things. So this song, this is a Valentine's Day song for your Valentine and mine, who's home, probably watching this. And I'll read the comments that she said later on. usually pretty colorful. Now, can we do this without the introduction that we've done? Yeah?
Well, we can just, you know, chug along a little bit.
Like that? Yeah, like chug along. I hear the train a coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. Sing my sad, sad song. I wish I was gentle, I wish I was kind, instead of just out of my mind. I wish I was stable, I wish I was schooled, not just an idealistic fool. I wish I could whisper to you to reality. I was wishing my wishes. Ooh.
come true. Cause I wanna give my best to you. And I wanna whisper to you words that will comfort you. And I wanna steal your heart. Hey, it'll be okay. I wish I was gentle. I wish I was kind. Instead of just out of my mind. Instead of just out of my mind. You know I'm just out of my mind.
These lights gotta be this bright for the TV thing right now. Can't see people. Oh, there you are. Hi, everybody.
We're here.
When I see your faces, it's a lot easier to play. When I can't see it, I always picture like monster-y people looking at me like really mean, like, come on, get on with it. Play something good. Oh, it's all you guys. Yeah. So let's say, where are we, Sharkey? Oh, I see where we are. You know, recently, we flew down to Florida. There's a radio station down there that wanted to do like an hour special of the band, WFNM, something like that. M&F. Thank you. Yeah, they're pretty. They're a nice big station down there, and they asked us to come down and do an hour special. And I didn't know till we got right outside the studio that we didn't have a drummer with us. You know, I'm not real comfortable playing like this nakedly, you know. I'm kind of shy. I like the drummer there, you know. You'll see me if you come to regular shows. I spend a lot of time back there by the drummer. I'll sing my bit and then I'll go hide back there with the drummer. So we did this hour-long special without the drummer. It went really good. They were really inspired. I think we did pretty good. What was I saying that for? Oh, so then the drummer flew down for this big festival we did down there, you know, and then, but coming back, we had another gig that I didn't realize the drummer wasn't going to be there for either. So we wound up playing at this, you know, unusual little coffee shop down there. It turned out to be, but it was me, Tink, and Sharkey playing. And,
It was in St. Augustine.
Fogartyville was the whole band was there, and that was a fantastic through the roof show. Then some other place we had never played before, and one of Frank Zappa's bass players came to the show. Somebody drug him along. Jim Pons, his name is, you know, and so Jim was there, and you know, he came like kicking and screaming that he was going to stay for the first set and get out of there. He didn't want to go see this folk band, you know, and we were more of a folk band than we ever were without a drummer there with us, you know. But Jim really took to us. He really liked us. And let me get a guitar on while I'm talking so it doesn't become like a Yabba Dabba festival. Anyway, he really liked the band. And then he came on online and he said to our fans, he goes, you know, I don't like pop music. You know, I played in this band. He was played in the Turtles too, you know. You know, with Flo and Eddie, you know. So, you know, he was like, I don't like pop music. But he goes, you know, I know this ain't true, but it was nice to hear. And he goes, this is the best band I've heard since the Beatles. So we were happy about that. We were stroked for about a week. You know, we got our heads. I almost wrecked the hat. So, in honor of Jim and in honor of Fluorescent Leech and Eddie, Frank Zappa, all the guys who would love a song like this will play a love Valentine's Day love song. Yeah.
Imagine me and you, I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together.
Do it, everybody.
Well, I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me. I lose my mind. Imagine how the world would be. So very fine, so happy together. It had to be the only one for me is you and you for me. So happy together. Well, I can't see me loving nobody but you for all my life. When you're with me, baby, the sky will be blue for all my life. My little China girl, you shouldn't mess with me. I'll ruin everything you are.
You know,
I'll give you television. I'll give you eyes of blue. China girl, she says, oh baby, just you shut your mouth. And when I get excited, my little China girl, she says, oh baby, just you shut your mouth. She says,
two sets, even though you're not supposed to do this with the concert window. thing, but you know, we're gonna do two sets. We'll just leave everybody at home. They can all go get a sandwich or use the bathroom at home as well. And they just can't buy merchandise. Figure that out. So Cindy's back there with merchandise if you want to go get stuff, especially if you're the person with the $3 million. So we thought, you know, we've done this particular song in the past. And we did this song right after we had this, Tink and I had this big long talk with Pete Seeger, you know. Pete was in our town a little bit lost. I think he might have got off on the wrong train, at the wrong stop. And he was stuck in Cold Spring. It's just the stop before his stop, you know. He lived in Beacon, like 10 minutes up the road from us. And I was down in the basement recording. And then all of a sudden I got this urge to go out to this one particular place in town. A place, you know, where we sometimes get coffee or sandwiches, but not that often. And I just got this really strong urge to go there. And then Tink was coming down the steps saying the same thing. She wanted to go out. So we went to this place. But she said, oh, they're closed already, you know. They close at 3. But I said, well, maybe we could call ahead, see if they'll make us a sandwich. And then she called and they said, yeah, come on down. We'll make you a sandwich to go, you know. So we went down there and they had the rope across the door. And they lifted the rope and let us in. And sitting inside was Pete Seeger. Oh, wow. Pete was in there on the phone trying to call people to get somebody to come pick him up. So we just watched. We didn't want to bother him, you know. So we just watched him for a while. We order our sandwiches, waiting for them to come. Then I said, hey, Pete, you know, what's up? He goes, I'm trying to get a ride. I said, hey, we'll give you a ride. Just relax. You don't need to call anybody. We'll ride you. Right. Oh, great, great. So he came over and sat at the table, split the sandwich with us. You know, we just opened this to-go sandwich. Everybody was happy that he was going to stay, and they let us stay. So we went back to Pete's house, and we talked to him for like, I think about 4 hours. We were, you know, Tink and I ask a lot of questions. We're very curious people. So, and we've done a lot of benefits with Pete. You know, Pete has tolerated us in the folk realm for quite some time. And he's the one who just said, you know, make sure you get people to sing along with you. You know, just don't be posers, you know. Like. So we, you know, we learned to do that sing-along thing. The ghost of my father concurs with that. He used to say, people should sing along when you play. You know, don't just dress yourself up in funny clothes and get their attention. But anyways, so we were hanging out with Pete for like 4 hours, you know, and then, you know, one of his kids came home and they were like, yeah, I think they're used to people coming in and invading the privacy. Like, what are you guys doing here, you know? And, you know, Pete, we tried to, you know, ease our way out, but Pete was like, no, let's exchange phone numbers. You know, we've done stuff together. Let me get your phone number. He's taking our phone number down and we were exchanging things. We went out to the car, and then Pete came running out to the car. And we were like, wow, why is Pete running out to the car? You know, we rolled down the window, and he said, can I talk to you about Toshi? And Toshi had just passed like 2 months before. And he came out, we got out of the car, and we stood there, and he talked in great detail about Toshi's last period of time together. And I don't know why he shared that with us. We were very moved to tears about it, you know. And then we just thought at that time, we thought, you know, well, Pete misses Toshi so much, he's not going to stick around too long, you know. And he didn't. He was gone like within 2 weeks after we talked to him, you know. So we were asked, you know, they had a lot of different ceremonies all over the country for, you know, for Pete when he passed, obviously, you know. And but in the town crier, the new town crier right in Beacon in Pete's town, they did a special one. It was kind of an internal one in the family, and everybody that played with him was in there. So Tink and I, it's only 10 minutes from the house, so we went down to it, you know. And we were in there, and it was a big line of people that were going to play, you know, like almost like 100 people or something. When we went in, somebody said, came up to me and said, "What are you going on?" And I said, "We're not going on, you know. We just came in to. We always feel out of place anyway. Still, after all these years, we always feel like when we're at a folk thing, you know, like, you know, thanks for letting us be here. You know, we really don't belong here." But they asked us to play, and then they came back and they said, "You're on in 2." I was like, "What?" So I went up to play, and you know, everybody was doing Pete's songs and stuff like that, and a song popped into my head, and I said, you know, I think even though I've never heard Pete do this song, I'm feeling the push to do this song and not dedicate it to Pete, but to dedicate it to Toshi. And so we're going to try to play the song. I hope we can play it, you know. It felt very appropriate, you know. And of course, when we played it, everybody lost it in the place, including me on stage. Oh, thanks, Sharkey. You're a good friend, Sharkey. Well, Suzanne takes you down to a place by the river. You can see the boats go by. You can spend the night forever. And you know she's half crazy, but that's why you wanna be there. And she serves you tea and oranges that come all away from China. And just when you know for certain that you have no love to give her, then she gets you on her wavelength and she lets the river answer that you've always been her lover. Trust her, for she's touched your perfect body with her mind. Now Jesus was a sailor when he walked upon the water, and he spent a long time watching from his lonely wooden tower. And just when he knew for certain only drowning men could see him, he said, all men shall be sailors, and until the sea shall free them. But he himself was broken long before the sky would open, forsaken, most human. He sank beneath your wisdom like a stone. And you want to travel with him, and you want to travel blind, and you think maybe you'll trust him, for he's touched your perfect body with his mind. Now Suzanne takes your hand and she leads you to the river. She is wearing rags and feathers from Salvation Army counters, and the sun pours in like honey on Our Lady of the Harbor. And she shows you where to look among the garbage and the flowers. There are heroes in the seaweed, there are children in the morning, they are leaning out for love, and they will lean that way forever. While Suzanne holds the mirror, and you want to travel with her, and you want to travel blind, and you think you will trust her, for she's touched your perfect body with her mind.
know you will trust her, for she's touched your perfect mind.
To play the Clearwater thing that they do, you know, the what's it called, the Big Hoochie Coochie Festival. So we were playing that, you know, I had never met Toshi, and we were going to the place where the artists eat, you know, this gazebo that they had by the river there, and all of a sudden, all the artists ran out of the gazebo. Everybody ran, like, yelling, like, screaming, woo, you know, like this, And Toshi came up to me. She'd never met me before. She came up and she grabbed me by the arm. And she put my arm in her arm and she said, come with me. And she walked towards the middle of the gazebo. I was like, and there was a skunk in the middle of it. And I'm a city kid, you know. We're scared of skunks or anything that moves. It's not a cat or a dog. But she walked right up to the skunk and she said, you're gonna have to leave, everybody's getting scared. She said very gently to this skunk. And the skunk looked up, I thought, oh my God, we're gonna get like sprayed. And the skunk turned around and did that weird walk, waddled out of the gazebo. I was like, oh my God, and it still didn't know who it was. And then somebody said, that was Toshi. Yeah. So, God bless Toshi. She educated me not to be afraid of skunks. So we're going to play one more song, right? So this one, this is on a new album that we did for Falcon Ridge, you know. We're very inspired, again, that the folk people, and a lot of you are the folk people, right? Aren't you folk people? We're so surprised that we've been allowed into the family and to pose so long as a folk band and tap all that folk money that you guys had, you know. Nobody else seemed to want it. You know? We're like, okay, we'll take some of that folk money. We get a bunch of kids. You know? So we're really happy. And then Falcon Ridge, you know, we played a lot of big folk festivals and all, but Falcon Ridge hires us every year. I think we played there like, I don't know, like 8 times in a row or something, right? At first, they used to stick us at the place right when everybody was going to dinner or lunch. So no matter what you played, everybody was just going, you know. But now we like, you know, they let us headline it quite a lot of the time. They put, you know, no matter who comes, we get the headline slot on Saturday night. And then they let us do the contra dance stand on Friday. We were terrified about that. You know, I was like, don't, you know, we're pushing it already that they're letting us play the folk festival. You don't want to go into the contra dance tent with what we do. And then, you know, as some of you know, it turned out to be this really cool thing. Tink's got the instinct, you know. She was the one who said we should go the folk route. I was like, you got to be crazy, you know. So, but anyway, so we've really, that. So if you've never been to Falcon Ridge, go this year. And if you go on Friday night, come to the dance stand. You can't believe it. I mean, we can do no wrong in the dance stand. Everybody comes so primed for something big to happen, and we walk out and they're screaming. It's like, you know, it is like the Beatles, you know? And so, you know, you could be as dumb as us, and all of a sudden you're chatting and all this stuff. It gets like really high energy in there. Sparks are flying. Every year it gets like more, I think our heads are going to explode sometimes. So come and see, come to that. It's really fun. You too, all you guys in the UK, come on over, you know, and in Canada, come on down. So we're going to play this one more song. So anyway, I was saying all that to say this. So we're really in love, you know, Falcon Ridge representing all the folk realm. Every time we go, we think, we got to do some new songs for Falcon Ridge people. We got to record some stuff before we go. So this year, about 3 days before we went to Falcon Ridge, I had 3 songs floating around in my head. And I said to Sharkey, come on over, Shark, let's record some stuff. And we did a session, and in a day, we did like we did two Sandy Denny songs. We like did all kinds of like cover things that we just didn't even expect to do, and we did them like in one or two takes. You know? It's like I think the Ghosts wanted to get stuff to the Falcon Ridge people. You see us, we messed up half of the first set, you know. But we went down and we laid down these tracks that were just they're pretty good, you know. And then we laid down three brand new songs that we had never played before. So then the next day, Sharkey mastered it. And then the following day, Tinket called in and she was getting impressed in New York. We picked them up on the day of Falcon Ridge and we're driving to Falcon Ridge, putting them in the packages and wrapping them up, you know. And we're thinking, hey, you know, we don't even know any of these songs, you know. So we popped the thing in the disc in the player just so we could hear the songs and learn them on the way to Falcon Ridge, so we played them. So that's the magic of what it's been like for us in the folk realm. Before that, we were in this really, really good rock band that had one name, you know, not like Gandalf, Murphy, and the Slambovians, or just one name, and everybody wanted to sign that band. But when you played clubs, the only people in the clubs were five other rock bands, and they were all standing like this. That's where I get that idea that, you know, the people are sitting there when I can't say. Yeah, nobody's coming to see them. Nobody's coming to see you except them, you know. But, oh yes, I mean, so it was Tink's idea, you know, to that we get to sit and stand in front of you guys and play and look at y'all, you know, it's really cool. You're drinking coffee, like you're saying, what are they singing about? You know? Awesome. So anyway, thank you very much. We'll do this song to end this set, and like I said, it's one of those new songs that's on our first folk album is called Folk One, and the new one's called Folk Two. So, I think you can even get that over there. Cindy's got some. And this one's kind of in a Slambovian style. It's kind of a, you know, we take extremes and put them together in a song, as you know. This one's kind of a cross between Pete Seeger and the Allman Brothers. Have we ever played it without the flute, though? Nah, okay, good. They look good, don't they?
Babies are grown up, children are old, future is prison. Past still untold, hearts scream for love in a world that's so cold. We gotta step out of time. Our bodies like Chevys, they're stronger than steel. Storms break the levees, truths are revealed. What should we say now? What should be healed? We gotta step out of time. We called him the man. We flew like the doves and we slipped in the sand. But we're still building cannons, making war plans. We gotta step out of time. Step out of time. Step out of time. Let's get our bodies aligned with our minds. Let's get our minds aligned with our hearts. Maybe it's there we can start. Time. time started again. Love, not religion, enemies, friends, all of these isms and vanities end. We gotta make the world right. Yeah, we know enough to know what's really cool, to know what is mean and what's just outright cruel. They say religion, but they're just evil fools. We just can't fake it. Step out of pride, step out of worlds where the love has all died. Let's live for each other, ride the new tide. We gotta step out of time. Step out of time, step out of time. Let's get our bodies aligned with our minds. Let's get our minds aligned with our hearts. Maybe it's there we can start.
Guys are really so good.